Well, hello there, and welcome to A Song for Yesterday. In 2023, the UK will be hosting the Eurovision Song Contest, and I thought it might be nice to get ready by looking back at a classic UK national final. Today we roll out the red carpet for A Song for Europe 1981. Our host, of course, is Terry Wogan. I'm always intrigued to see in these old contests whether Terry's in a dinner jacket or his own suit. Well, as you can readily see, no Dickie Bow in 81. Budget cuts, probably. In fact, the whole show was cheaper than before. 8 songs instead of 12, 7 juries instead of 14, and the Royal Albert Hall is just a memory. We're in the BBC TV theatre, probably fitted in between a generation game and a crackerjack. Still, let's see what the songs were like. The first song in 1981 was Not Without Your Ticket from Headache. You can fly away, you don't have to pay, be your stowaway. In a space balloon, you can reach the moon by tomorrow noon. It's a lovely day on the Milky Way with you. Not without your ticket, don't go. Not without your ticket, don't go. Calling your band Headache seems a bit of a hostage to fortune, but remember, the UK has sent songs like Rock Bottom, The Bad Old Days, Why Do I Always Get It Wrong, and Don't Play That Song Again. Maybe Headache will get lucky at Eurovision too. Well, no. As you can hear, Not Without Your Ticket nodded vaguely in the direction of reggae. This would work about as well for Headache as it eventually did for Ricky Sorsa at Eurovision. It's not quite Jamaican Holiday, is it? Oh look, wasn't she in Mabel in 1978? Song 2 was All Cried Out by Gary Benson. I'm all cried out, can't find a tear to save my life tonight. Without you here it can't be right. Your love has turned to doubt, and it's left me all cried out. Gary Benson had taken part in A Song for Europe before, as a composer rather than a singer, and perhaps he was pushing his luck here. Interestingly, if he had won and gone on to Dublin, he would have been following on directly from Norway's Finn Kalvik, who also sat in a stool, sang a gentle ballad, and strummed on a guitar. Considering that this isn't as good as Aldri y Livet, and it scored no points whatsoever, I think the Song for Europe juries were right to look elsewhere. Now then, steel yourself for something rather special. Song number 3 was For Only a Day by Unity, and if you haven't seen this one before, you should really treat yourself. Unity's lead singer, Sue Glover, was a legendary backing vocalist, and at Eurovision, she'd previously been both a swinging dolly bird for Lulu and a soul siren for Joy Fleming. This time round, more of a Victorian governess looking after a group of sickly orphans. I mean, look at that one. She's probably dying of consumption. This really is too much, and as Oscar Wilde might have said, you'd need a heart of stone not to laugh your head off by the end of it. How Terry contained himself, I'll never know. If I had the artist gifted eye. Song 4 was Wish from Beyond. Now, Wish from Beyond sounds like science fiction to me, which reminds me, have you ever seen those Doctor Who episodes featuring shop dummies that suddenly come to life and kill people?
Watch out. Look, there he goes. Yes. Well, of course, the singer probably wasn't under alien control. He was more likely to have just been depressed by this gloomy dirge they were trying to sell. And I can't imagine the drummer was too happy either. For his big close-up, he's doing nothing more than gently tapping his trouser legs. This one's barely rock and roll kids, never mind rock and roll. Another dreary song, and at the halfway point, as the scene shifters shifted, this was looking like a disaster of a song for Europe. Surely, with these songs, the UK had no hope of winning in 1981.
Now, song number five is Making Your Mind Up, it's called.
Oh, you were ahead of me, weren't you?
Who, incidentally...
Of course, things improved by an order of magnitude from this point onwards. Song 5 was Making Your Mind Up, and while it would probably have won from any point in the running order, coming after all those awful songs surely helped it get that landslide victory. And although there's nothing new to say about the song itself, it is worth taking a good look at this performance, because it's miles better than the Eurovision version. The vocals are spot on, and the orchestral arrangement is much sharper. More saxophone and less strings compared to Dublin. If you're someone who still mourns for Lena Velitis or demands justice for Peter, Sue and Mark, watch this and give Bucks Fizz another chance. This shows how good they are and why they deserved all that came their way in the weeks and years afterwards. Song 6 was Have You Ever Been In Love by Jem.
Have you ever been in love?
Have there been times to laugh? And times you really want to cry? Finding reasons to believe us. You should die a little each year.
This came from the same team as Making Your Mind Up, and the ghostly woman at the keyboard is Nicola Martin, who later sang backing vocals for Bucks Fizz in Dublin and sat beside Mike Nolan in the green room. Have You Ever Been In Love, though, is completely different, and this strong ballad shows just how good a songwriter Andy Hill is, although, to be fair, he was no Cheryl Baker when it came to performance. Even if this had won a Song for Europe and Eurovision, I still can't imagine Andy duetting with Roy Castle on Record Breakers. Number 7 was Where Are You Now by Leslie Carling. And the hits keep coming. The juries weren't especially impressed with this, but I just love this Crystal Gale style ballad, and Leslie's deep voice is gorgeous. Lots of emotion here, but I wonder if it perhaps hurt her chances that she didn't get a smile at any point, even after the song had ended. And lastly, Don't Panic by Liquid Gold.
Just control yourself, repeat your eye, baby. Oh, don't panic, you can help yourself. When I cry, baby,
panic indeed. This is a great bit of disco fun performed by a very odd looking group. There's Elaine's liquid gold jumpsuit, the gap-toothed guitarist, the bass player, who would have needed a lot of baby oil to get into those leathers, and that very lively drummer. I bet the guys from Beyond were terrified of liquid gold in the green room.
All right,
after all this, we rushed into the voting with little or no interval to speak of. Spokespersons included such Song for Europe legends as Ewan Thomas in Cardiff, Ray Moore in London, John Mundy in Manchester, apparently wearing Noel Gordon's glasses, and David Stevens in Birmingham, who voted first and bizarrely gave top marks to Wish.
In second place, song number two. Very early, yeah.
Wish.
Mercifully, it was all one-way traffic after that.
Number five, we made our minds up to give that top marks 15.
Whoa. Song number five, making your mind up, we like that one too, we gave 15 votes.
Song number five, in a very commanding lead, 55, next best.
For number five, making your mind up, guess what, we gave it 15.
Another set of four marks.
Quite a surprise here, Terry. Bucks Fizz got 15 points.
You don't tell me. They seem quite pleased. But the winning song, the song that's going to go on to represent the United Kingdom at the Eurovision Song Contest in Dublin very shortly, is song number five, Bucks Fizz, with 97 points, Making Your Mind Up. Of course, well, Mike
Nolan from Bucks Fizz accepted the award and made friends with Terry over their joint Irish connections. And then it was time for the winning reprise. Bucks Fizz, of course, went on to win and to be stars. Liquid Gold got a Top of the Pops appearance for Don't Panic, and Have You Ever Been in Love was later a success for Leo Sayer. However, the second best chart position in 81 for any of the acts went to Beyond. Not for Wish, but as backing for prima donna's Kate Robbins with her hit from Crossroads, More Than in Love. I hope they gave Noel Gordon her glasses back. And what about For Only a Day? Well, it lived on for a couple more years at the Miss World competition. You can't keep a good song down, can you? Well, that's it from A Song for Europe 1981. But before I go, I suppose I could tell you how I would have voted. Not that you care, really. But here we go. Song number one, Not Without Your Ticket. Not the worst, but very close. 6 points. Song 2, All Cried Out, now that really was the worst, 5 points. Song 3, For Only a Day, it was awful, but it was hilarious, 8 points. The keen-eyed among you will notice that this scoreboard certainly doesn't reorder. Song 4, Wish, 7 points. Song 5, Making Your Mind Up, well, I agree with the juries, 15 points. Song 6, Have You Ever Been in Love, 3rd place, 10 points. Song 7, Where Are You Now? That was my runner-up, 12 points. And song 8, Don't Panic, 9 points. Well, there you go. As song number 5 glows very faintly on the scoreboard, that's it from me. From A Song for Yesterday and 1981, goodbye.